So the next presentation is about a thing called wearables, which is the concept of blending fashion and clothing and attire and sort of things that we as humans use as self-expression, but also as clothing ourselves, and making the electronic jump with it and being able to blend the magic of electronics and fascination with electronics with clothing and stuff of that nature. So, all right, without further ado, wearables.
So this, just real quick, this is the hat, and I brought two little spools of connective thread, so I can't like show everyone how to make it because I don't think they have any else here, so I don't know. But it's just, we'll get into it. What am I doing? I'm talking about wearables. So what does constitute a wearable encompasses a really broad range of things, like as much as anything can be worn on your body at any point. One of the first ones that was really popular is the one on the left. It's a bicycle, it's a jacket that has LEDs sewn in to do turn signals as she's biking. The switches are in the sleeves. And so that's like a full jacket. The two things in the middle of the, are also with biking. One of them is like a removable light, and then on the bottom is a helmet with LEDs in it that also can be used to signal turns. And so those are all really like, well, I guess the clip one isn't, but the jacket and the helmet are definitely different than maybe like the Pebble, which I'm showing here in the production run, and then kind of what is all into it. Like a Pebble is kind of more of a traditional electronics project. It just has to be very small and then built for durability. Whereas like sewing LEDs in a jacket has some special considerations for the, you know, how to do it or something like that. And along with practical examples, there have been some more in the fashion world taking over some of this technology stuff too. So the top two pictures are Katy Perry wearing out of the design firm Cute Circuit. Cute Circuit is doing a lot of work with fashionable wearable technology. And so they've clothed her. That the first is at the Met Ball. The one on the right is her at the iTunes Festival last year. And the skirt there, these do animate. They kind of have, you can either have text, or I think she's singing a song called like Roar or something, and it does like a little lion, and it's really cool. And then the dress down the bottom there is being shown at in Chicago, and it is all LEDs, and they all animate, and it's spectacular. And then kind of in the middle of that, like trying to be both have utility and then still be fashionable are things like the Ringly, which is like the Pebble without a screen, but it does notifications. It vibrates when your phone gets a notification. And then there's a little LED that does, you know, one of five colors, depending on what kind of notification it is. And then the bracelet there is designed by Rebecca Minkoff, and it also does a vibration with notifications. And so it's kind of this meld of fashion and technology that's really, really fun. So as you set off to design your own wearables, there's a couple things you'll need to think about. There's soft circuits versus hard circuits with wearables. Soft circuits being conductive thread, conductive fabric, conductive Velcro, anything that can kind of be sewn into fabric itself to work as the circuit. And so on the left is an owl with conductive fabric on both sides. And so as you hold both sides, the LEDs can light up as like it's like a switch. The middle is a lily pad, which I'll talk more about, but that's basically an Arduino that's special for wearables. And this is showing how you would sew in the kind of like what you would do with regular wires, have a power wire and a ground wire, but instead you actually stitch in this wire around it, and it's just it's conductive thread. The other option is doing hard circuits, which is taking regular wire, regular Arduinos, regular sensors, whatever, and modifying the garment or modifying the electronic component to work in the garment. So this is the first two are just showing how you would take wire and stitch it onto a garment and have everything that's really great about wire, but then still have it be inside of clothing. And the picture on the right here is the underside of the LED. I have a skirt in the other room. I don't have any demos with me because it takes so long to set up. So come see me at my table and I will show you all of this for realsies. But the skirt has an LED panel, and then on the, that's just using regular wire, regular LEDs. But then they're all kind of held into place with a series of pockets to keep them from shifting around and to keep them from being uncomfortable. So the if you are aren't familiar with hard circuits, you're gonna get familiar with them this weekend, hopefully, but soft circuits are kind of not covered by a lot of traditional technology, like how you would learn stuff. So there's some benefits and some drawbacks to soft circuits, and again, that's with using conductive thread and fabric. So the main benefit is it's very, very straightforward to add electronics. You get immediate feedback on what it looks like, and you just stitch everything up, and you can kind of go as you as it feels right, or as you you can kind of develop the electronics on it very naturally. It ends up being conductive thread is very flexible and it's very securely fastened. There's no soldering involved, and it's very approachable for people that may not necessarily have a traditional like electronics background, but do have a traditional crafting and sewing background. And there are a group of people that are really taking off with this and doing really good demos and tutorials online to show kind of what's possible with soft circuits. But there are some drawbacks, mostly to do with conductive thread. Conductive thread is basically little metal fibers that have been kind of woven together to make a thread. If you are used to regular thread, your problems with conductive thread is it does kind of can get twisted up on itself and not kind of easily, so you have to be careful when you are sewing with it to make sure that it's all, you know, kind of drawn out. It also loses resistance a little bit more quickly than wire, where since it's you're passing electricity from fiber to fiber, when you get like a wire is just normally like one piece of metal, and then you just pass electricity through that metal. But when you pass it from fiber to fiber, you can lose conductivity a little bit, or you lose conductivity more. So it's made might be suitable for large or spread out areas or for lots of LEDs, which is what I'm all about. So that's why I don't use conductive thread for the big LED panels. Conductive thread quality can vary between vendors. So what a lot of people that aren't techies buy conductive thread for is they have a really nice pair of gloves they like, but they want to use it with their phone. And so there are people that are selling conductive thread that works really well for that, but it isn't going to work necessarily for like passing electricity from your finger to your phone through a glove is a lot. You don't need as much conductivity if you're passing electricity like along from a battery to an LED somewhere. So SparkFun and Adafruit both do sell it. I would recommend probably buying that from them because they are selling it specifically for electronics projects. And it's not really documented. There's a couple people out there, etextilelounge.com, has been doing a lot of reviews of conductive thread from various sources that aren't like the official ones and kind of talking about like the ones that just don't work. And then conductive thread is not insulated, it's just the wire, like the metal part. And so you need to make sure that when you are designing your garment that the power and the ground threads aren't touching. So that's what to keep in mind with soft circuits. When you get into the actual components of what to build, you are going to have a couple of choices here too. So the top part of here is just a bunch of components that are specialized for wearables. So by specialized, I mean they're very flat and they have very large copper areas like for the terminals, and then with holes that you can sew through. So on one side, on the left is the Flora, and then on the right is the lily pad. The Flora is sold by the lily pad is sold by SparkFun. The Flora is sold by Adafruit. They both kind of have similar kind of components between the two lines. So, and so then what you would do with these then is run conductive thread through the hole and then out into your garment where you'd want it. And so they have various sensors. This is the one second to the left is just a smaller Arduino. And the ones in the middle are LEDs that are kind of the same thing. With these are NeoPixels, so you have an extra line for getting the data to know what color it's going to be. And then another option for you is to take regular electronic components and then modify them to work. So on the left there is two normal LEDs. You take the terminals and you kind of curl them up and then flatten them out. and then you can run conductive thread through that, and that's how what I made this hat out of is just taking the normal LEDs and flattening them. And then you can take surface mount LEDs, and they for beading, they have this crimp tubes, which are really small little metal tubes that you usually use to crimp together to hold the wire. And you can solder those to surface mount LEDs to make them sewable. And then on the last thing there is EL wire. You can buy, it's just kind of a thicker wire. And I take regular soft vinyl that you'd get from a fabric store and cut it up into strips and loop it around and sew it together to make like an edging. And then you can sew that to the trim. And I have an example of that at my table. So for designing wearables with this stuff, there are some things that you're going to want to keep in mind. And this is mostly advice from my little my little foray into wearables. But the first part is to start simple. If you're going to do a shoe and you're going to buy a shoe, buy the cheapest, simplest shoe ever, because your first prototype of it is not going to probably work. So instead of getting my friend Kaz over there has she puts it in Converse shoes, and those are pretty simple. They're one layer thick, and you just kind of can sew through there. Where if you were to use a tennis shoe or something, that's going to be very, very hard to kind of piece apart and to sew stuff into. I do a lot of things with skirts, and I'll talk a little bit more about that later. But and then also be thinking of your batteries right away. I know that it's you want to get into the LEDs and the sensors and the light up and everything, that's great. But batteries, you sort of need them to work, so to make anything work. And they're ugly, and they're heavy, and they're a pain in the butt to deal with, but you're going to need them to make anything work at all. So my first skirt that I ever made, I was just kind of like, whatever, I'm going to make it to go to a Skrillex show, and it's going to be great, I'm going to light up. And I was like, then I got to the end of making it, and I'm like, okay, so I'm got to put batteries in here somewhere, whatever, I'll just do it here. And that here was at the bottom of it, kind of on my leg. So I get to the Skrillex show, and I'm trying to dance, and this battery pack is going everywhere, and just I don't know, really harsh my vibe, but you want to be thinking about batteries kind of from the get-go. The batteries that I do have, a good place for them, especially if you're going to be at a concert and not sitting down a lot, is by on your lower back. So I do a lot of waistbands now that you put batteries into, and they can kind of be held into your lower back. If you were going to sit down a lot, maybe off to the side would be a little bit better. The first time I gave this talk, I was at the Arduino MN. I'm from Minneapolis, by the way, so I was giving it at the Arduino MN meeting. And I kind of started with the circles. I was talking about how to build a simple garment, because I had mostly done skirts. And then someone tweeted this, and I thought it was really funny. It's kind of the same ratio here. But just deal with it. I know we might not be making skirts, but if you're making pants, you can kind of extrapolate what I'm trying to get at here by just starting with a simple garment. So the skirt thing that I'm doing is it's basically you cut a donut of fabric, you put elastic on one side, hem the other, and you're good to go. And it's a really, really simple way to do something. If I screw this up, it's going to take me a half day of me being mad at myself having to make another one. It's really easy to modify. When I was doing the waistband to put the batteries in, since it's just a donut of fabric, it's pretty simple to kind of think through how am I going to attach an additional waistband, how am I going to modify this to fit the things that I need. And if you were doing this with a pair of pants, it's probably, if you go out to Walmart and buy a pair of sweatpants and just sort of, you're not going to end up with sweatpants, but just go with sweatpants first and just kind of go nuts on those. And you don't have to, worry about wrecking something that you actually care about. You can kind of go to that at the end. So I do a lot of stuff with LEDs too. So my pro tip for that is test them first. Light shines through fabric in different ways. Light just shines in different ways. The first LED array that I built, the LEDs were very pointed. And so it was very, very hard to see what any of the things that I was drawing with the LEDs were. Another project that I have, I brought it with me because it didn't really work out, is I did this skirt with EL wire, and I wanted to do a pleated skirt but with the EL wire inside of the pleat. So in my imagination, this worked that the light would kind of shine out, and so you could kind of see it through the pleats. But EL wire doesn't really project light. It just sort of glows, and so it didn't really turn out that well. But it looked really awesome in my imagination. And then lastly, like terry cloth is really awesome at diffusing light. So again, I have this all at my table, but this is kind of what you start with this stuff. So that top picture is just what it looks like without anything on top of it. And those are Space Invaders, but it's kind of hard to tell what it is because the light's too pointed and it doesn't really diffuse very well. So when you throw, when I was planning this out, my first thing was like, okay, whatever, it'll look better when I have fabric over it. So I threw a piece of black fabric over it, and it still was very, very pointed and hard to see. Like, the Space Invaders, they kind of looked like blobs moving, and it was really, really hard, and I was like, oh, this is the worst. Like, I can't believe this whole planet is going to, ruin forever. But my dad was like, okay, relax. What about this? And he threw, a shop towel on top of it, like a white terry cloth towel in his workbench. And I'm like, that is so cool. It's diffusing the light perfect. But I don't want to wear a towel around me. Like, that's not cool. But it still was really cool when you threw black fabric over that. The LEDs are bright enough that they will shine through a couple layers of fabric pretty easily. And you get all of the benefits from the light diffusing off from the terry cloth that when it gets to the black fabric, it doesn't have, can't absorb that much. So that ended up being really perfect. So if you're having problems with light diffusion, with something wearable like a fabric, try running it through terry cloth first. Hot glue for more of a, non-fabric things has been really good. If you do a dollop of hot glue on top of an LED, that can really diffuse it out really nicely also. So if you're looking for more ideas or resources for this, I mentioned eTextile Lounge. She does a lot of Instructables, a lot of stuff on Instructables, which she links to. But then she does reviews on different kinds of conductive thread you can buy off Etsy or eBay. And then also some different techniques for wearables. This Koba Kant at DIY section has a really great list of options with photos. Some of their links there's a lot of links that are dead on there, so sometimes you just get a picture and then you kind of go down the search hole and then get sad, but it is a kind of a good place to look at if you want some ideas. Instructables.com seems to be where people are putting a lot of the wearable tutorials that are out there. So this is a really unruly link, but if you go into the category of technology and search wearables, it's a really good resource for finding ideas. And then if you're looking at doing a workshop or something, there's people at MIT wrote a guide for doing that with some examples of cut these out of felt, and then cut this fire truck out of felt, and you can put lights, and look, it's a blinky light thing. Great. So hopefully I gave you some ideas. Please see me. I have all of the things over at my table, and I would love to show off. The end part of this here is a lot of this wearable stuff just hasn't been done before, and so you can't think that it's not going to work. Just someone hasn't gone through to develop it yet. The idea of taking strip LEDs and kind of soldering them up into an array, I was like, I don't know about this because no one's ever done it before. But it's just no one has done it before. It isn't necessarily it can't be done. So just if you find a good mentor to kind of help you with the technical limitations, you can kind of go nuts and just see what works and what doesn't, and just be ready to kind of evolve with that process as you evolve your knowledge. So thank you. I don't know how much time I did, but
all right. Thank you very much.